Everybody, it's your gal Cal. I'm back with another new tutorial. This is my easy bronzy makeup look. So here we go. It's pretty simple. So just kind of get ready with me. So I'm gonna start with my Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Floss filter. This is a great thing if you want some all over shine and lift to your skin. Another great dupe for that is the L'Oreal Invisible Lift Luminous Serum Tint. So that one is another good one. The reason I wanted to get the Charlotte Tilbury and spent quite a bit extra money on it actually is because it has a shade range. So like this one like really blends easily into my skin tone. It's not like like a rose tone or a gold tone. It's like a skin tone with added glow. So, I mean, in that regard, it has a shade range. And so you can, you know, really get a tone that matches and makes it look even more natural for your skin. So I just take that kind of all over generally and just healthily apply that to my skin. Next, I'm gonna go in with my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. In the summertime, I'm not a big foundation person. Actually, I'm not a super big foundation person anytime. This foundation, this concealer is probably my favorite drugstore concealer. It's really comparable to the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, and that's a cult favorite. And I just kind of take that in all the areas that I have discoloration. And I take kind of a little stipple brush and I just go over that. And if you use a brush, it gives a really natural finish and really light skin-like finish. And they call it a stipple brush because it's really good for that stipple motion where you just pat it in and just very slight swipes. It's not a, it's more of a, you know, a dot, 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 dab, dab, dab to get a very natural skin-like finish. But I do kind of swipe, I guess, over my eyelids and in that crease area because it's hard not to swipe there. As you can see, I've got some like redness on my nose, but look how much that took away my redness with just the quick, like what's left on my brush. So it's got really good coverage and it just gives a really beautiful, natural kind of flawless skin-like finish to the skin. And honestly, that is plenty of coverage for me. I don't really need anything more than that. Sometimes I go in extra, but I find a lot of times if I use my brush, it gives me the best application. So next I'm gonna go in with my Wet n Wild contour palette. I'm gonna use the bronze shade. And I'm gonna take that in this little Elemar brush, tap that excess off, and then remember, start at your kind of at your under your temples, and then pull it down to your cheekbones in a circular motion, back and forth. The reason you start up here is so that if let's say you like over applied product to the brush, that way it's not going straight on and you just over applied a ton of product onto your cheek. That way by the time it gets to your cheek, you've already kind of worked a little bit of it off. Because if it's way up here in the temple, nobody's really going to notice if you over apply versus if it's straight in the middle of your face. So this bronzer is, I love it. It's a great bronzer. It's a matte bronzer, so it doesn't have any glitters or shimmers in it. And that I feel like helps give you a really natural look. And so you just build it up to your desired coverage. I'm going for a more bronzy look this time because it's summertime. And I also just put some over the bridge of my nose because I've got color there. And so I want people to be like, oh, you've been in the sun. How, you know, how luxurious. And then remember, always take bronzer down your neck as well. So never, ever, ever, ever forget to bring it down your neck. That's probably like makeup 101 to a T, because if you don't take the bronzer down your neck, you're going to be a floating head. And I've had many a year where I fall prey to the floating head syndrome. So definitely something to remember. And if you're gonna have your hair pulled back, just bring it back a little bit down the back of your neck too, so everything just kind of blends together and matches up. So that's bronzer. Next, I'm gonna take my Milk Makeup Cream Blush in the shade Work. And I'm just gonna take that on this kind of firmer brush, a big brush. And I'm gonna take that brush kind of over this so I pick up some of that product. I don't wanna put the bullet straight onto my skin. I want it to be a more healthy, natural glow. So by taking the brush over the cream blush, it helps you really get an all over better application of your blush. And I think that's such a beautiful, kind of almost berry toned blush that looks really beautiful. And I just put a tiny bit on my chin and a tiny bit fairly faintly across my forehead to kind of tie it all together. So then for the eyes, I just picked up this new, I think it's pronounced Kaja or Kaha, I'm sure it's Kaja. Little trio, so it kind of comes in stock like this, and you can open it and it has three eyeshadow shades. Of course I went for the neutrals. So I was thinking I'd like to use that little new trio I've got, and then I'm gonna go into my Tarte Lip palette. This is the Tarte Lip and Bloom palette to get my mattes going, because everybody needs a good matte. Normally I would say if you're doing some kind of eyeshadow look that is gonna maybe have a lot of like glitter falling out, do that first and then you can clean it up and go in and put on your base makeup, but I didn't even think about it today. I'm just kind of winging it, and I'm just having a good time with my makeup. I'm not going anywhere with this look, so I'm not trying too hard. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the shade Jet Setter here. It's this one in the top. Take it on a little fluffy brush, and then I'm just gonna apply that into the crease area of my eye. And this works as a nice, cool tone transition shade and helps me just kind of keep it all looking really nice and natural. You always, whenever you are doing like a wild eyeshadow that's not a cream, like something that has sparkle and glitter, you always want to have some kind of transition shade. It's just a base, something to kind of ground the sparkliness of whatever shadow you're putting on. And it kind of defines the shape of your eyes, because like for me, it kind of makes my eyes just a little more, gives them more depth. And then I'm going to take that same shade and just bring it down the lash line a little bit, whatever's left on my brush, just like that. And then just make sure you blend. It doesn't have to be perfect. Eyeshadow is not really a strong point for me. It's just kind of, you know, I do it. And then let's go into this little quad. I think I'm gonna use the middle shade, this beautiful kind of bronzy gold shimmer. And I'm gonna take it on my finger and I'm gonna press. Oh, that's really beautiful. So it's a very like yellow gold shade. On my eye, it looks a lot more yellow gold versus the bronze gold that I saw in the pan. Sometimes an eyeshadow, when you put it on, you think it looks like one color in the pan, and then you put it on, you're like, whoa, that's a completely different color. That happens to me a lot. Once I put on my eyes, I'm like, oh my gosh, that was so different than what I thought it was. So then you just build that up with your finger gently pressing on your eyelid to the desired kind of amount. And then let's go into the top shade, which is the really light gold kind of champagne, and take that on a different finger. And then put that just really lightly in the inner corner for some highlight in the inner corner. And like, see here, I brought that sparkle like pretty far down onto my inner eye, which I don't want it to be that far down. So what I'll do is I'll take one of my makeup wipes And I'll just remove it with the tip of my finger and clean that area up. And try to get all those little gold shimmers out of there, because you can always take and remove things and put them back on. There's no need to get it perfectly right every single time. So then let's go back in with that concealer we had in the original, start of this. And we'll just put back a little bit, a little dab in that spot. And we'll go back in with our original brush. We'll just really gently add that back in. Now look at that, like it never even happened. I feel like I make the funniest faces when I do this stuff. I'm gonna bring that a little bit back over my nose because I don't know if I liked how much that was bronzing up my nose. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, so then let's do our little eyeliner trick that I always do. Just a little bitty wing. You know, let's go a little more dramatic with it this time. Nice. My wings are always, you know, a work in progress. That looks pretty. Okay, so, that was the L'Oreal Flash Cat Eye in brown. And then this is the Milk Kush Mascara. That's new as well, a new Sephora grab. We'll just do a healthy coating of that on the lashes. I've gotten so used to wearing brown mascara that whenever I put black mascara on now, I'm like, oh my gosh, so dramatic. And I'm not a big person on curling my lashes, but if you have really straight lashes and you feel they need a curl, definitely go ahead and curl them. My lashes just, they don't hold curls for some reason. I don't know why. And they're already so like big and do what they only want to do. So I'm kind of like, all right, I won't fight you. It's kind of like a kid. You don't want them. You want them to eat their dinner, but they don't want to eat it. I'm not going to fight you. Okay, so let's do eyebrows. So I said in another video that I use the same eyeliner pen that I use for my eyeliner for my eyebrows. And I just fill them in like I would use like a pencil kind of thing. And I just have a few sparsities. They're not super, super serious, but I do like to fill them in. And just kind of clean up the shape of the arches. Yeah, just something really kind of delicate and simple like that. With eyebrows, I feel like err on the side of natural. Don't try to overly fill or, you know, whatever. I don't know about you guys, but eyebrows are like, they've always been a work in progress for me. And I feel like when we look back on our pictures, they're the thing that, for the most part, we're like, oh my God, what was I thinking? And I feel like that always happens whenever I've tried to like go away from the natural look of my brows, the natural shape of them, or the natural kind of look of them. So that's over the years, that's just been my go-to. Okay, now that I'm looking at my skin, I think I want a little more bronzer. It's summer, I want this to be like a really golden, beautiful, kind of look. I want to feel like a Victoria's Secret goddess. And they are so, so bronzed. And usually I don't wear this much bronzer, but I'm having like extra fun for this look. So we're just gonna go in with extra bronzer for fun. And every time you put more bronzer, more goes on your neck. If you're like me and your jaw kind of like, you have a little kind of fat under your chin, a good trick for that is to bronze that area so that it kind of shades itself and it looks kind of like you've got some darkness there. It's not just like an extra like flab of skin. Kind of little trick I learned. Okay, now for the highlights. For the highlight, I think I'm gonna go in with a little bit more of my Hollywood Flawless Filter. In my Highlight 101 video, I showed you guys how to apply a powder and a liquid highlight. And personally, the liquid highlight is my favorite. And I just apply it in mostly these areas. And I think it just gives the healthiest glow, the naturalist look. And keeps everything looking, you know, naturally glowy and gorgeous. So that's stunning. I hope the camera's picking that up because in the mirror, it looks just like healthy skin. Nothing more, nothing less, just healthy skin. And when the sun hits it and it gets that natural glow, oh, so pretty. You guys can see how pretty that looks. It's really gorgeous. Okay, so that's everything but lips, and I'm so excited to show you guys this. This is the Dior Lip Glow Oil, and it's in the shade Rosewood. I picked this up today at Sephora. It's something I've been wanting forever, and it's my birthday in 2 days, and I just had to treat myself. So it has this huge doe foot applicator, and it's like a lip oil. And it goes on so beautifully. Okay, so that is my golden bronzy makeup look for summertime. You just, you know, tussle your hair up. Alright, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please feel free to like it and subscribe to my channel. Hit the subscribe button below down in red. Feel free to comment what you'd like to see next, and I'd love to see you again. Thanks so much for watching.